It's impactful. It's informative. It's inspirational. It's intentional. It's the Max Life Nation Showcase experience with Apostle and Lady Bridget Hilliard and their iconic showcase guests. Get ready for an uplifting faith experience, providing answers to life's problems, strategies for success, and living lessons of faith. It's time for the Max Life Nation Showcase.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Max Life Nation March Showcase. I'm Bishop John Edmondson. Tonight's gonna be fantastic. Listen, you need to go ahead and text somebody, tweet somebody, Facebook somebody, FaceTime them, open your window, yell out the window, tell them Max Life Nation March Showcase is on and you don't wanna miss it. Tonight is going to be awesome. Apostle's doing a teaching, and you don't want to miss that. His masterclass teaching, anytime Apostle teaches, it's off the chain. It is awesome. You don't want to miss it, not just you, but others. So get the word out, because Apostle's going to drop nuggets tonight that you don't want to miss. It's going to be incredible. And then there's a special iconic guest that's going to be on tonight that's going to change your life. You're going to be exposed to some things that's going to change you tonight. Can you shout tonight in your house? It's going to be fantastic. And then there's giveaways. You know, Apostle and Pastor Bridget, they always are giving away stuff, but you got to be registered. You have to be registered. You need to go to MaxLifeTV.org. MaxLifeTV.org. If you're not registered, you can't get the giveaways, and you want the giveaways, so make sure that you do that. I'm so excited tonight. I'm here, I'm in the house, I'm in the studio. It's going to be awesome, and you want to stay tuned. You need to be locked and loaded tonight. You don't want to multitask tonight. You want to make sure you're focused, because revelation is going to be dropped tonight that's simply going to change your life. I'm so excited. I can't wait. This night is simply fantastic. And again, get the word out, please. Share with folks. Let them know. Get them to jump on tonight, because tonight is going to be worth it. Apostle and Lady B are here. They're ready. They're going to share. And it is going to be so wonderful tonight. I've been waiting for this. I couldn't wait for this. And I know you're excited. But guess what? You know somebody else that needs to be on tonight too. So we want you to get ready, get prepared. If you haven't registered, again, MaxLifeTV.org, register. If you don't want giveaways, I don't know what's going on. You know you want the giveaways, especially the ones that Apostle and Pastor B give away. So go register now, get set, get your notepad ready, get focused, because we're about to go in, and it is going to be an awesome, awesome, awesome time tonight. I'm so excited. Anytime we can sit at the feet of Apostle and Pastor B, it is a wonderful thing, and tonight is going to be no different. It's going to be incredible. I know Apostle is itching to share what God gave him, and I can't wait to hear. So get yourself ready. Be prepared. We're about to go in, and it's going to be incredible. Did you go register yet? You need to register. Don't mess with it. Register, because when giveaway time comes, you're going to wish you had registered. So do it right now. Get ready. I'm excited. We're getting ready to go to Apostle and Pastor B. Are you ready? Well, guess what? It's time to go. Let's go.
All right, this is the day the Lord's made. I'll rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to our showcase.
Yes, Max Life Showcase. And of course, so many different things tonight. Of course, when you came on, you heard the DJ. So we have a DJ.
Can't believe I got the DJ.
Yeah.
People think I'm so old school, I would never have the DJ.
Yeah, I would think you would never have one.
So you think I'm old school too?
Well, you are.
No, I'm not.
What are you? You're 72.
Almost. I'm relevant. That's what I am. I'm relevant.
Okay.
Yeah, like Reverend Hilliard is relevant.
Oh my God.
That's what it is. That's what it is.
Praise him.
Yeah.
Well, I want to encourage everybody to make sure that they register. If you haven't registered, maxlife.org/talk, you can do that. And on that website, you can also sign up for anything that we announced tonight is available for you on that same link. So I want to encourage you to go maxlifetv.org/talk.
Yeah. So tonight's going to be good. Our iconic interview
is actually live.
It's going to be live tonight.
Yes.
That's going to be great.
Yes.
And that's going to be another. I told everybody this one was going to take our experience
to another whole nother level. Yeah.
And so we even had a guest MC tonight.
Yes, and all the way from New Jersey.
All the way from New Jersey.
Yes.
And he did a great job.
Flew in from New Jersey.
Yes.
And he brought his wife.
Yes. Amen.
Yes.
Now listen tonight. I'm going to be sharing tonight in the in my masterclass session. I'm going to be sharing faith for multiple
income streams. Yes, I saw the notes.
Yeah,
it's going to be amazing.
It's having the freedom to use your faith for money.
Yes.
And that's almost, people don't want to talk about that.
Right.
They need money, but they don't want to talk about that. So I really want everybody to like and share. I want to get our numbers through the roof for this. We had great registration.
Yes.
We had amazing registration for this. And so I just know tonight's going to be real, real, real special.
And we've got some great giveaways to give away tonight. I'm excited about the giveaways, the opportunity for people to get merch. And then, of course, the opportunity for the barber school giveaway that we're going to do.
Yeah, the scholarship, $15,000.
Yeah.
Valued at $15,000.
Yeah.
And somebody's going to get blessed tonight.
Yes, yes.
Yeah,
so I really want to encourage those of you who are watching. Maybe you know somebody who wants to go to barber school. Encourage them to watch as well. They could just be the ones to win the scholarship.
Yeah. And then, you know, we have a question.
We have a
polling question. We want to know.
We have a question or we have answers?
But a question, a polling question.
Okay.
And the polling question is, who is most likely to succeed in developing multiple income streams, a male or female, a man or woman?
Okay.
You know, who's most likely, as we talk about these various income streams, who's most likely to succeed at it? And so I want to see what it's going to be.
How do you do the poll?
I think this, we just same
maxlifetv.org/talk.
Yeah.
And you do the poll.
You can do the poll.
Yeah.
And then at the end, we'll find out what all of y'all think. But now, what do you think it's going to be?
I think it should be females. Why you look like that? Well, the bottom line is we're go-getters. We're going to make it happen. We're going to be forge ahead. Why are you quiet?
Because it's going to be the men.
Well, why would you?
It's going to be the men. So the men out there, I want y'all to call in. And come on, stand
not
up for
us. Maxlifeitv.org/talk.
There it is on screen. Come on, do that. I mean, don't sit back tonight. I can't have you sitting back. Our honor is on the line.
Oh, my God. But it's
our honor is on the line.
It's a poll. So even
it's a poll.
Even a man might vote for women succeeding, I mean, having multiple streams of income. Because, see, here's the thing. Women can do more things with their hands than men can do. We're just like that. We just have it
not
like that.
Not necessarily.
Yes, absolutely.
No, not necessarily.
Because, like, think about this.
Okay, come on, come, bring it.
Okay, so let's see, what feel would a female do that a man is not as good as?
Okay. See what I'm talking about?
I got one. You probably wouldn't feel as comfortable with a male masseuse, but I mean, they do have
They have. All right, come on with it.
And then a male manicurist or pedicurist, they. So there are some, but you probably would feel more comfortable with a female. Let's see.
All right, see what I'm talking about, man? Come on. I need you to go, and I need you to get a part of the poll. I'm excited.
We should poll the people who are here and tell them
I'm not bothering with these people.
No, I'm talking about they can go do the poll when we're on a break or something.
Well, they can if they want to, but right now I want everybody. Listen, tonight's going to be so amazing.
Okay.
Tonight's going to be amazing. And what's my next move?
Your next move is we're going to go back to the DJ in a moment, but not right this moment. We're really encouraging people to make sure that they go out and go to maxlifetv.org/talk so they can be a part of the poll so we can see who wins. How many of you out there think the women are going to win?
They put your hands down in here. Put your hands down. I think right now we're at that moment, aren't we? I think, aren't we at the moment for the DJ?
Oh, they just the clock stopped. I was looking at the clock.
Yeah. And so I think what's going to happen is we're going
to
go.
You don't have to think what's going to happen. You just have to look at the schedule.
Are you trying to correct me?
Well, I'm just.
Is that what it's going to be? Is that what it's going to be?
But you made the statement, I think.
DJ, get ready. DJ, get ready. DJ, get ready. And after the DJ is we're going to come back with, I think they're going to roll into a video.
I think it goes, yeah.
No, they're going to roll into the iconic video, and then, boom, he's going to be live.
The interview.
The interview is live with, the voiceover messed up his name.
Oh, it messed it
it's
up
called
real
him
bad.
David.
Emanite.
Sorry about that, David.
Every
Sorry
time
about
it that. Came on, yeah. I just bust out
yeah.
laughing.
Yeah, but we'll give you his real name.
Emanite. Not a thing.
Okay.
Emonitier.
Yes. Okay, DJ, we're in your hands. And then after that, I think it'll be followed right by the video. And then we're going to all be on the stage together after the video. And we're going to talk it up. I can hardly wait to talk. Ask him some awesome questions.
I wonder about, what he would say about the poll.
Well, we're going to see it in a minute. All right, DJ, in your hands. Boom.
Thank you so much. It's an honor. It's a privilege to always spend or invest any time with you. And for you to have me be a part of this conference, the Strategies Conference that you've had for now 28 years, I consider it an honor and a privilege.
Hey, man. Well, you know, you're an innovator. You are, businessman extraordinaire. And so a lot of people have heard about you, but they don't know you.
Right.
And so in this, we're going to get a chance to know you. I think maybe, didn't you come to Strategies and sit in the back or something like that?
Yes.
Years ago?
Years ago.
What I try to tell business people, David, is that there are principles that, yes, we may use in ministry.
Yeah.
Those principles can also apply in business as well.
Absolutely.
So let's get busy. Let's get busy. How long have you been in direct marketing, in entrepreneur? Come on, tell us a little something about Mr. David. I'm going to try to get it right. I'm on the TA. Did I get it right?
That was nice.
Yeah. Did you want some
clothes? It was good.
All right, good.
Well, it's been 19 years for me. I started at the age of 21. I had done what my parents told me to do. My parents told me to go to school and get good grades and graduate, and I tried. I started off in kindergarten. I was at the top of my class in kindergarten.
Okay.
Eventually got to college, but I didn't finish.
Okay.
Didn't finish. And society said that if you didn't have a college education, that you probably weren't going to amount to anything. But that's not what God said.
Gotcha.
And at 21 years old, I was very fortunate to meet a friend of mine that would introduce me to network marketing, direct sales. And I fell in love with it. Apostle, I did. I fell in love with the concept of helping somebody else get what they wanted, and in return, I would get what it is that I wanted.
Yeah.
And I just fell in love with it and started my journey 19 years ago. So it's been a blessing.
Okay. And on that journey, and I like the word journey because it's a journey.
It is.
In life, it is a journey. In ministry, it's a journey. Yeah. In the marketplace, to be successful, you have to see it as a journey. You learn a lot of things along the way. And so I just kind of want to know, what are you doing now?
Yeah.
What are you doing now?
Yeah. Well, recently, about a year ago, we started our own network marketing company. I built businesses for other companies over the last 18 years. And I felt an impression from the Lord to start a company called Envision You. And we started it October the 3rd, 2022. And Apostle, within our first year, we've done over $22 million.
Say that again.
Yes. Within our first year, we did over $22 million in sales revenue.
Wow.
Open in 50 plus countries around the world. God is just blessing us tremendously. And it's just the beginning. We've got big goals and big plans and a huge vision to impact a billion people. And I believe we're going to get it done.
Wow. Amazing. Amazing.
Totally amazing.
And guess what?
He's here live. He's live.
Yeah, he's here with us live. And so, you know, we got a whole lot of stuff in the can, but I said, why do it in the can when David is here with us now?
Absolutely.
David, what's happening?
Hello, sir. How are you?
Outstanding. Outstanding.
How are you?
How are you, Mom? How are you?
Good.
I always call when I call him. I always ask,
where are you in the world?
Where in the world are you? Because you've been traveling, man.
I have. Yeah, we've been about four different countries just this month. So
wow.
Just this month.
Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Wow.
All right. So how's the company doing?
Company's going fantastic. We thank God. It's our 18th month now, and we're actually having our biggest month ever.
Wow.
This month right here.
Okay.
And so we're excited about what's going on. We've got a major convention coming up May 24th to the 26th in Atlanta.
Yeah.
We're going to have over 2,000 people there.
I plan to be there.
Yes. We'd love to have you.
Yeah, we'd love to have you. Yeah. All right. Listen, here's the thing, and why I wanted you on is because for many, another stream of income could be a direct marketing, you know, career.
Yeah.
And I think, you know I did it years ago.
Long time.
It has to be over 50 years. Because you didn't do it when I was married to you. I'm just saying.
I love both
okay,
of you.
Okay. I was in Amway, okay?
Right.
I was in Amway.
Was that? That was 50 years ago. Then.
Okay, it was 50 years ago. I was in Amway.
Mm-hmm.
And I did good.
Yeah, I know
now,
you did.
Now, people didn't like to see me come because I'm ready to sell you, Doc.
I went through that too.
I mean, I could put my circles up. Mm-hmm. I had my washing powder and all that stuff. I had all my products. All my friends had.
We're still drawing circles today. Now you come to my presentation.
I saw your presentation.
I draw circles.
I saw your presentation. But you know, it was another stream of income for me back then.
Yeah.
And we were good at it. But there are a lot of things that people. How to maximize? That's one. A person is thinking about it.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily your company, but you've been around and you work with several companies.
Yeah.
There's something you have to look for. There's something you have to do.
Yeah.
In order to make it. Mm-hmm. So kind of just talk to us about. A person says, okay, I want to get in this. I want to get involved in direct sales,
mm-hmm.
multi-level marketing. I have you on set.
Yeah.
What do I do?
Yeah. Well, let me first say thank you again for having me come on the Max Life Showcase. Mom, Lady,
yes.
Appreciate you again. And I love talking about the industry of network marketing. A lot of people don't really understand it.
Okay.
They think it's a pyramid scheme. They think it's a scam or something like that. And it's really not. It's a real business.
Right.
For real people that really want to go out and not just create another stream of income, but they can really create a full-time income as well.
Correct.
They really can. But I would say the biggest thing that they need to know coming in is that it's going to expose them to personal growth.
Mm-hmm.
See, personal self-development is really the starting point for someone to succeed in any business. So you can get involved in a network marketing company, but if your mindset is not where it needs to be, it's not going to work. But when you're looking for the right opportunity, I would say number one would have to be timing. You know, in business, timing really does matter. When you get involved in that company, timing in the marketplace, mm-hmm. all these things really do matter. That's number one. Number two will be leadership. As you know, everything rises and falls on leadership. So you got to look at the track record on who you're going to be doing business with. This is absolutely important. It's very, very vital. I think leadership would have to be 1A, 1B. And then, does that company have value? This is big. And this goes outside of network marketing too, because people will pay for value. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What network marketing companies do though, is see, they had already created the powder. They had already created all the value. They created all the products. You didn't have to manufacture it. They created all the technology. They handled all the logistics for you. So all the value is there. They're providing the products, the services, and all you do is you share that value with the world, and the world will exchange their money for the value that you have.
Gotcha.
So if you're not in network marketing, it's because you've created the value for yourself, and now you've got to get it out there in the world. Network marketing companies create the value for you. Mm. And they do the heavy lifting for you. And that's why I love it. And then last is you got to look at the right compensation plan. Am I going to be rewarded handsomely for the work that I do?
Got it. Yeah. So now you started your own.
I did.
And how is that going?
You know, 18 months in, it has been a walk of faith, Apostle. It really has been. It's a completely different world from the first 18, 19 years that I've been in network marketing, because I was more in the field, just building my network. This is more so you're building the infrastructure of the company. So there's so much other things you've got to be concerned about outside of just building your team. But it's been the most rewarding.
Gotcha.
You know, the lives that are being changed. We've got countless amount of six-figure earners now, people that earn six figures. We've got people that are earning seven figures in the company. You're talking about 18 months in, 40-plus countries. We've got 50,000 people in our company right now.
Wow.
Yeah, 50,000.
Okay.
That's awesome. Yes, sir.
Okay, now let's go back a bit. Let's go back. Let's go back when you came to me years ago, and you wanted me to mentor you. I said, man, listen, I don't have time.
I get the time.
But keep coming.
Keep coming.
And you began to listen at a series.
Yes.
Talk about that.
Yeah.
And how that series changed your life.
I'll never forget it. It was right around June or July of 2011. Mm-hmm. And the audio was How to Eliminate Doubt and Unbelief. But here's the thing. I was here for two out of the three nights that you actually taught it.
Okay.
It was a three-night series. The first night, you taught on the Word, right? Mm-hmm. How the Word is really, you know, teaching and studying. That's how you get the faith. Then the second night, you talked about visualization. You talked about seeing. The third night, you talked about the emotions, right? It completely transformed. Everything I know about faith comes from that audio. Everything I apply today, everything that I still teach, and I've taught it now. But I always give credit though.
I will tell people. Now that's the truth.
This is who I got it from.
Yeah,
that is the truth. Yeah. Because I began to hear, this guy's teaching your stuff.
Yeah.
And I said, well, you don't lie. He said, but no, he's telling everybody he got it from you.
Yeah.
And I say, oh, seriously? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so, you know, that's what I want you to really talk about.
Yeah.
How it affected you and then your leadership team.
Yes.
Because I found out that you were giving that thing away to others.
Oh, absolutely.
You shared it with us.
Absolutely. So what happens is when you come in contact with information, because you teach on that, there's four factors that impact your belief system, your environment, the credible people around you, repetitious information, and then life experiences. So when I got in contact with that information, I didn't just listen to it one time. I listened to it over and over and over. I'm talking for years. If I show you my phone, it's actually part of my phone. Like, I still listen to it today. So when you have that information on the inside of you, it starts to transform you. But now as a leader, transformation only now materializes when you can give that information to people around you. Because if you're the only one growing, you can only go so far. But if you have your team growing, now you can go really, really far. Because now they have the same mentality that you have.
Gotcha.
And that's when it becomes really dangerous.
Well, Lady B started listening to it again. And
I listen to it probably almost every other day.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah. And that's it. But faith comes by hearing, not by having heard.
Yes. Absolutely.
And I don't think a lot of people value that, that yes, you heard it once, but you can't just that doesn't suffice.
No, it doesn't.
For faith to keep coming, you need to keep hearing.
Yeah.
Right.
And so what had amazed me, I went to one of your, you had me speak at one of your, I don't think it was a banquet. What do you call it? It was a banquet.
It was a leadership. It was a leadership training.
Yeah.
The one in here.
No,
in
not the one in Houston. Okay. The one when I first met all your crew.
Okay.
All your
guys. Florida. Yeah, that was it was like an all-white party.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it was amazing. Yeah. All these young guys coming up to me, who were millionaires.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm just saying you weren't the only one. Mm-hmm. You had created this group. All these guys are millionaires. Yeah. And they're coming up to me saying, I listen to it every day. My family listens to it. And I'm going, really? And it was an amazing experience for me to see the impact of that teaching.
Yeah.
Totally amazing.
Yeah.
Totally amazing.
It works. I mean, it works in ministry. It works in business. It works in family. I've watched you use it in many areas of your life. But obviously tonight we're talking about finances. It absolutely works for finances, but you got to work it.
Yeah.
And the key thing is you got to be patient.
Mm-hmm.
You got to be patient to let the word do what it's going to do. And don't live in worry or be anxious. So just be anxious for nothing. Mm-hmm. Right. So I just kind of live by, if it's in there, then I'm going to believe it.
Right. And the good thing is that you're giving it away free tonight.
You took my thunder.
Oh. You giving that away?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to give that away.
I know, that's what I say. He always gives away.
I had them buy it.
Yeah.
I didn't just give it to them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You had them buy it?
I had to buy it, absolutely. NewLight2.org. Go look at resources and look it up and buy it. That's how you get it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I was going to give it tonight.
I see.
To those who register.
Okay. And I, like David, I have it on my phone. Like, I can pick up my phone anytime, mm-hmm. day or night,
and I
can listen to it. Because once I got it, I just downloaded it to my phone, and it's like
it's in there.
One of my apps on my phone. Just
So tonight, I want to be a blessing.
That's a blessing.
That's a blessing right there.
That's a transforming blessing.
Yes.
That I'm saying, okay, I'm ready to put this in your hands.
Mm-hmm.
Because I believe, for people who are watching this, I believe that they're really serious.
Yeah.
And that is what I want to sow into their lives tonight. Well, the next question is how you going to get it.
Right. And so they get it by the same way that they were doing the poll. It's maxlifetv.org/talk.
Mm-hmm. So, go on.
And you just go on there, and then it'll tell you can just get the free register for the free faith message. And the message is how to eliminate doubt and unbelief.
Now, for all of you who've already registered,
you
don't have to register again.
Right. They're gonna
if you pre-registered, you get it automatically.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, but those, we always have thousands who watch.
Yes.
Yeah.
Who view. Now, so if you are a viewer and you know you didn't register, but you're viewing and you're going, this is great, I want that. And you ought to want it because I call it my millionaire maker.
No, it is.
Because it made you a millionaire, made other
several
millionaires. So listen,
several.
I'm saying, listen, this is something I want to give you, but you got to act now.
Mm-hmm.
You got to act now. Go there and.
No, Pastor, I don't know if you know this. I was in an apartment when I was listening to that.
Wow.
Talk about that.
I wasn't rich yet.
You weren't rich yet.
I was in an apartment, a one-bedroom apartment, listening to that audio over and over and over and over again.
Wow.
And at that time, since then, I've earned at least $60 million since then.
Wow.
So before, and
would
I
would you
still,
say that again?
Yeah.
Since then,
mm-hmm.
listening to this.
Yes.
Applying it,
yes,
you've made $60 million.
Yeah, plus. Yeah.
What you say?
I said it. It's the truth.
So you would advise somebody if they really want.
Oh, listen. If you study that information, and apply the information, that's the key. You have to apply the information. Some of the stuff on there, it may seem corny. But just understand it's biblical. That was the thing for me. It lined up with what the Word of God said and what men and women in the Word of God did. And like you said in the audio, if he'll do for one, he works with principles. So
yes.
I just have to work the principles and it's going to work. And what's so amazing about it is that today it's easier. Mm-hmm. With technology.
Wow.
Yes.
Yeah. Right? We're talking about multiple streams of income.
Right.
With social media and technology, it's so much easier for someone to create wealth, but they have to get over this. They have to get over that stinking thinking, right? That limiting belief that they're not supposed to be wealthy. Everybody is born to be rich. That's what I believe.
Amen. That's Bible. No, that's Bible. And that's my showcase tonight. My master class tonight is about this.
Mm. Yes.
Let's get our minds straight.
Yeah.
Let's get rid of, you said, stinking thinking. Let's get rid of that poverty mentality that's been imposed on us by our environment.
Yes.
And let's understand God wants me. Boy, you know, I get in trouble when I say, especially with the traditional people, God wants me to have surplus.
Yes.
A lot.
Yeah. Says the blessing God of the wants Lord, me make to, it rich.
He wants me to have it. And I remember, y'all know, I'm in a little raggedy building.
Yes.
And that's when God taught me the principle.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And see, God, the principles that's on this, the message, the doubt and unbelief, that principle, those principles made me rich.
Yeah.
You say you're rich? Yeah. Why would I be trying to tell you to get something I don't have?
Right.
You follow me?
Right.
And, you know, for those who want to, you know, I don't know. Well, match my giving. Mm. That's what I always say. Match my giving and then we can talk.
Facts.
And that normally shuts everybody up who wants to be like that. But here's the point. It didn't just work for me.
Mm-hmm.
It worked for you.
Worked for.
I got sons and daughters in ministry. It's working for them.
Yeah. Right.
So I'm saying to the person now who's saying, wow, seriously? Yes. I got to get to my lesson now. Mm-hmm. I got to go to the lesson. But salvation, your covenant gives you the right to have abundance.
Absolutely.
And that's what I'm going to be sharing in my part tonight. Mm-hmm. I think we're going to end the session. But listen, we're going to come back.
Yeah.
So what you need to do, those of you watching, if you want it, I'm giving it to you. I'm sowing it into your life as a seed, believing it's going to be a blessing to you. Mm-hmm. All right? I'm going to teach, and then we're going to come back, and we're going to have this session called Ask the Millionaire.
Oh, wow.
I'm looking forward to that.
Ask the Millionaire.
Ask the Millionaire.
So they're going to have the opportunity
to ask questions.
Yeah, to send their questions
I don't even want to know what the questions are before they ask it. I just
boom.
Just spit them out to you.
Mm-hmm. All right. So we're going to have this part of interacting, and that's what we're going to do.
So if they're thinking about questions that they want to ask the millionaire right now, they can go on and start sending them
in. Yeah, they can start sending those in.
Yeah, so you can send them in by doing the maxlifetv.org/talk, and you'll see a little thing that says Ask the Millionaire. And so you can start sending your questions in. And when we get to that segment, we'll just shoot the questions to David, and he's going to answer them right off the cuff.
Right off the cuff.
Okay, we got to get ready. We got to get out of here and get ready.
So we're going to go back to the DJ.
My DJ!
And then after the DJ, I think you're going to teach.
No, I think after DJ, I think I'm going to have my MC. Yes. John's going to come back and tell people that if you don't go and get this, eliminating doubt and unbelief, you stupid. No, I can't say it. No, but that's what we're going to do now. And then I'm coming back. I'm ready to teach this thing.
I'm excited.
I am ready to teach faith for multiple income streams.
Yeah.
DJ, we're in your hands.
I need y'all to help me clarify. Did I hear Apostle say that this whole teaching, eliminating doubt and unbelief, he's giving away for free? Somebody put free in the chat. Did you hear that? And then David, I'm not going to say David's last name. But David, after he listened to it, he's made $60 million. Now, Apostle said, if you don't get this tonight, he said, I'm not going to say what he said. It's just not wise. You need to go ahead and register maxlifetv.org/talk. You need to go register and get this series. If it's worked for one, it'll work for somebody else. How many know tonight we're talking to multimillionaires, income streams? You're sitting there saying, God, give me an answer, and your answer is being given to you tonight. So you need to go get eliminating doubt and unbelief. It will change your life. He said 60 million. Come on, somebody. Now listen, April's right around the corner. April is just around the corner. You know what April is? That's Dr. I's Shiro's League, and we're so excited. Shiro's League is just off the chain awesome. So we want you to check out this commercial by Shiro's League, and we'll be right back. Check this out.
Age is more than a number. It's a story of triumph, learning, and boldness. This is Dr. Irisha inviting women of all ages to Shiro's League Conference, April 24th through the 27th. From young visionaries to esteemed pioneers, this conference is a melting pot of experiences and wisdom. Together, we'll share, grow, and empower each other no matter the stage of life you're in. Seize this opportunity to be a part of a diverse and vibrant community. Register now and join us in this celebration of timeless boldness. Register at SheRoseLeague.com and I'll see you at Shiro's League 2024.
Did you see Dr. I's fist up? She's getting a clarion call. It's time to get bold. You need to go register and make your way to Houston for Shiro's League 2024. It's going to be awesome. And then guess what's coming up after that? Love City. We're calling youth from all over the nation. You need to get to Houston. Love City is phenomenal. My youth from our church have gone and they love it again and again. So I want you to check out this commercial about Love City because you need to get your youth registered. Check this out.
Yo, it's the kid, it's Pastor Ivan, and we slashed the price. It's time to reserve a spot for your team group for June and July summer camps here at Love City USA in Houston, Texas. Listen, we have slashed the price just like last year. We are doing the same thing this year for this four-day summer camp experience at Love City USA, and I'm telling you, it's going to be absolutely amazing. For just $199 per camper, we are making it possible for more teams to attend. Love City USA is in the shadows of downtown Houston, and it is a place of fun, fellowship, and faith with first-class air-conditioned dormitories, a cafeteria, and state-of-the-art worship facilities. Our theme this year is Chosen. We want each and every team to understand that they have a purpose and are chosen by God to make a difference in life. Team groups will come from across America this summer to experience this amazing teen-sensitive spiritual encounter, and we would love to host your group. For more information, text LCUSA24 to 54244. Yeah, it's right there on the screen. Or go to lovecityusa.com and treat your teen to an experience that will last you a lifetime. I want to see you in Love City. Can't wait. Let's go.
Love City this year is going to be so incredible. Get your youth there. Well, it's time. Somebody shout, it's time. It's time for Apostles Masterclass. I'm ready for it. But I've been waiting to say this because we got a DJ tonight. DJ, drop that beat.
Well, 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 this is the day the Lord's made. I'll rejoice and be glad in it. Are y'all ready for this word tonight? Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that ears are anointed to hear, hearts are anointed to receive this word tonight, and our lives will be transformed by it. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. I need y'all to pull in a little closer on this. Listen, I'm going to be teaching now for just a few moments on faith for multiple income streams. This is, you know, this is a two-night event, so I'll be teaching tonight and tomorrow night. And so I want you to get ready for this. Those of you who registered, you have the worksheet. On the worksheets are all of the scriptures that I'll be using. So I'll be referencing a lot of the scriptures. Some of the scriptures that I will just be, stories like the opening story, I'm going to be kind of sharing that. And then you'll be able to follow along with me on those. But I want to maximize my time. You know, there's a scripture in Ecclesiastes chapter 11 and verse 2. That's a very powerful verse.
And in this verse, it says, invest in seven ventures. Yes, in eight. Do you not know what this, you do not know what disaster may come upon the land. So here is a scripture talking about multiple income streams. Now there's the question is always asked me, does God want me to believe for money? Does God want me to believe for increase? And there's a story there in 2 Kings chapter 4 where this widow had her husband left her in debt and she needed money. She goes to the prophet, the man of God, and he gives her an income idea. Now, what's so important about that is for what God will do for one in principle, he will do for another. So here is an example of a person using their faith in God for increase. And so that's what I want to do tonight. I want to dispel the myth that God doesn't want you. You shouldn't talk. No. There are more scriptures in the Bible about money than there are about love. What? Yes. And so what I want to do is dispel the myth. I want to pull back the curtain because I want you to understand God wants you to have money. He wants you to have more. Now, you say, listen, you don't even need to get in the chat and complain. I concede your right to be broke and poor, and you're still going to heaven. I concede that. So we don't have to argue in the comment, leave that out. I'm telling you, and just go watch somebody else. But there are those, God said, who would hear my voice. And not only hear my voice, but it would motivate them to take the step that's going to change their lives. Amen and amen. And so, when I began to look into scripture years ago, I'm in 1980, my needs had needs. I'm in the little raggedy building that I always show y'all. And that is when God began to open my eyes. And he began to open my eyes to see that life could be different from me. Yes, that's where I was in a little raggedy rundown building. And that's when God told me I could release my faith for money. I never heard that. I grew up in church, and growing up in church, you know, we was, you know, saying after a while, by and by, things are going to be better. I didn't know that we could release our faith for our needs to be met, and our needs to be met in abundance, and that we could have surplus. But God showed it to me then. And then God showed me how his plan worked. And what I want to show you tonight, that the established plan in scripture for financial increase is there. And not only that, but multiple streams of increase. Now, one of the first scriptures God showed me was in 3 John 2. It says, beloved, wish above all things thou mayest prosper, be in health, even as your soul prosper. Now, God began to show me how I was made up. Put the graph up here, body, soul, and spirit. That we are spirit beings. We live on the inside of a body, and we have a soul. That's 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 23. Now, it says, I will prosper relative to the development of my soul. Well, what is my soul? My soul is made up of my mind, my will, my imagination, my emotions, and my intellect. My mind, my will, my imagination, my emotions, and my intellect. So I will prosper, be in health, have abundance to the degree that I will develop my mind, my will, my imagination, my emotions, and my intellect. Now, everything I'm going to share with you is straight out of the Word of God. It's straight out of the Word of God. And so, to walk in any truth, you have to have several basic things. Number one, a revelation, understanding at your level of comprehension. Number two, you need a role model. You need to see that truth lived out in the life of another, either historic or contemporary or both. Then next, you need what I call a regimen of faith, a systematic way of applying the word in your life so you get results. And then finally, you have to have a righteous resolve, a godly reason for wanting it to work. And so now, when I look at the covenant that I have at salvation, I'm amazed at the benefits that are in that covenant. So that would be my point. The established covenant of kingdom financial increase, it's there. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, the Bible says, and his righteousness, and all the other things will be added unto you. So life for you as a believer ought to be better than life was for you as an unbeliever.
life for you as a believer. Well, hey, I'm a believer. Life's not bad. I understand. That's why you're listening now. Because the will of God does not automatically come to pass. The will of God does not automatically come to pass. The will of God comes to pass relative to the development of your faith. And that's why I'm here tonight, and that's why I want to teach you. Because when I want to know what the will of God is, I don't go on television and ask a celebrity who doesn't know God. I go to the Word of God, and I find out for myself from the Word of God. So when I go to the Word of God, I find, oh my God, that first of all, God talks about ways to make money. What? He gives us the justifiable ways from Scripture of how to make money. But now, let's talk about this whole idea of prosperity from the Scripture. Deuteronomy 8:18, he says he gives me the power to get wealth. Then let's put some of those up. Psalms 112, verses 1-3, and there it is. Come on, help me. Psalms 112, and there it talks there about how wealth and riches ought to be in my house. I love Proverbs 10 and 22. Proverbs 10, 22, and I remember one day I was talking to a guy, and he says, well, that's not, I said, no. No, it's in the Bible because it's for everybody. It says, the blessing of the Lord and maketh rich, maketh truly rich, and he adds no sorrow with it. So he said, well, no, that's, I said, well, who is it not for? No, it's in the Bible because it's for us all. Now, I could just go all the way down the Scripture. The Bible says a good man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. All of these are Scriptures that God's promising that in this covenant that he has with us, he's not saying we got to wait in the sweet by and by. He's saying you can have it right now. What? I'm going to get to why. Because, see, God wants me to be involved in good works. Well, I can't be involved in good works if I don't have the resources to be involved in good works. So here are some of the ways that God says scripturally are okay or ordained for channels for giving, I mean, for receiving, for established channels for kingdom financial increase, and that is through working, through gifts and inheritances, through compensation for damages. Now, we're not talking about faking damage. You know, that's not the will of God for you to fake an injury, all right? And then wise investments. And so money coming through those channels, the Bible, that's ordained in the Scripture. Now, those of you who have the notes, you know you have the Scripture references for all of them. Yeah. What I want to look at next is the character that I have to have. Now, here's the real test. Is that when God blesses me, he has more than me in mind. When God, you might want to put that in the chat, in the comment. When God blesses me, he has more than me in mind. And so the Bible says we are blessed to be a blessing. So that's where the character, because when God blesses me, watch this, I owe him. What? Oh my God, I owe him. Put that graph up here, because I owe God several things in my blessed state. In my blessed state, I owe God my time. Yes, I owe God some of my treasure. What? And I owe God to teach others, and I owe God to testify of it. You get that? So I'm not just getting things to heap up on myself, but God wants me to be a good steward. And the Bible talks about how Paul writes to Timothy, and he tells Timothy, now you tell those people who are rich in this world. They were. So watch this. Everybody in the early church wasn't broke. Woo. No, he says, you charge them who are rich in this world to be not high-minded, not trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who gives us richly all things to enjoy. And he says, and that they do good works. That's it. So God wants you to be a person who increases, this is the partnership, so that you can help finance the kingdom of God, so you can be involved in good works. That's the plan of God. Now that's God's plan. So when we're talking about finances for the king, finances. We're not saying, okay, just money so I can get a new house, or money so I can get a new car, and all that. No. See, God explained that to me years ago. Years ago, when I'm in a little raggedy building, that's where he taught me how to live by faith. He began to let me know that I would be blessed so that I could be a blessing. And I understood that. And I'm going to give you the principles in just a moment. But now, we're talking tonight, today, about multiple income streams so that I can use my faith so that I will not have just one income stream, but multiple income streams. Well, what do you know about that? You just a preacher. And you don't know nothing about no multiple income stream. All you know how to do is preach. Now, that's where you're wrong. No. That's where you're wrong. See, everything I will ever teach you is something I lived out myself. And so I just made a note of the various business enterprises and things that Lady B and I have had or presently have over time. Income stream, ministry, of course, aviation, buying and selling aircrafts. What? Yeah, I used to own a dry cleaners, a chain of dry cleaners. What? Yeah, a chain of dry cleaners. And in my chain of dry cleaners, I had a multi-level concept and had associates. Yeah, okay, yes. A video game room, I had multiple. I had multiple locations with my video game room. And then real estate. Lady B buys and sells houses. And I got to tell you, we had one time, I think, in one of the presidential campaigns years ago, and this one of the candidates didn't know how many houses he had. And I said, I don't know, because that's Lady Bridget's thing. She buys and sells housing. At that time, I didn't know how many houses that we had in our portfolio. All right, watch this. Right now, I'm involved in an AI venture. I have two other partners. What? Speaking engagements. Watch this. I had a computer company once. What? Yeah, we were we were doing Lady B and I together. We had a computer company, and we were doing business for several companies there. And then consulting. Not only that, but then online programs. That's just a few. Lady B probably could add to this. But that's on my resume that I can tell you about multiple streams of incomes. Watch this. That don't get you out of your purpose. Now, my main purpose and calling is to preach the gospel. And that's the main thing that I'm called to do. And I gotta tell you, God is more than generous to me in that. But put graph number three up, because graph number three, I wanna show you streams of incomes. And all streams of income will come under these seven categories. And that is, you're able to sell your time. And that's what most people do. They sell their time. Well, yeah, your employment and that sort of thing, or service. Next would be the income stream of what I call, you'll be leveraging your expertise. You can constantly be in a consultant or developing online programs. The third one would be, now these are not in order of priorities, but this, listen, watch this. The third one, leveraging the sale of products. Yeah, and those products could range from goods or opportunities. Watch this. Then that would be the leveraging of branding. Now, branding is when you made a name for yourself and people will pay you to use your name. Wow. Pay you to pitch their product. Amen. All right. And pay you to endorse their products. And then the other one, the next one, would be the sale of money. That's with your stocks and your bonds and your investments. And then the sale of access. Now, what do you mean access? Access could be where I have property, an Airbnb. I'm leasing you access to my property, or I'm leasing property to you and I'm getting income from it, all right? And so then the final one would be events. And that is a person who just, you could call it a service, but there are people who put on events and profit off of sponsoring events. Now, many times an income stream could consist of many of these put together. But as you look at it, they will all fall under these seven basic streams.
these seven basic streams. Now, what we're going to talk about now is in the Bible, I want to show you financial increase in the Bible, because it's important to know, if I can see in the Bible that God helps somebody get money, I can know he'll help me to get money. Because he's not a respecter of persons. So I look in the Old Testament and I see the widow who needed to pay her bills. And the prophet gives her a creative idea of going into the oil business. He helped her identify a need, because that was, everybody had empty pots of oil, but she had a little oil in a cruise. Now, here's another thing. I might get into this. Everything you need, you already have. You may not recognize it. And tomorrow I'll teach you how to recognize it. But everything you need to increase, when you look in the Bible, every miracle, God used what people had. Many times they didn't value it. They didn't know they had it. He had to tell the apostles, go and see, when he got ready to feed the 5,000. They said, oh, we don't have any resources. He said, go and see. And when they came, they minimized what they had. And they, you know, what is this among so many? I'm telling you that you have right now. What? You have it right now. You just don't recognize it, but that's why you listening to me. That's why I'm going to teach you how to recognize your hobbies, your skills, and things like that, that you can monetize right away. All right, watch this. Now, that's one situation. We'll go to the New Testament. Jesus had to pay his taxes. He needed money to pay his taxes. And Peter needed money to pay his taxes. Jesus began to give Peter an idea to go and fish, used a profession he had, created a stream of income so he could pay his taxes. Now, the Bible says, boy, this is a powerful passage here. Bible says there in Isaiah 45 and 3, they got to put that on the board. Isaiah 45 and 3, I will give you hidden treasures, riches stored in secret places, so that you may know that I am the Lord, the God of Israel, who summons you by name. Did y'all put that up? I need it on this screen. Y'all got it on another screen. All right. I will give you hidden. God, this is a promise from God. And God made this promise that he says, I'm ready to give you an idea. Ooh, I'm ready to give you, to show you how to tap into the stream of money. Okay. Everybody get all watch. Now, here's what God showed me years ago. First, God told me, he says, there's no shortage of money. No shortage of money. Nobody's burned it up, and no shortage of money. Now, there may be a shortage in your house, but ain't no shortage of money in the world. And so God says, now, many people have a pie mentality. Pie, okay? And the reason people get jealous is because with a pie mentality about money, when somebody else has, then there's less for you. But God said, no, son, don't think about money as a pie. Think about money as a river flowing through the land. And the river is always flowing. And everybody has their field next to the river of finances. And those who know how to best irrigate will get more of the river or more of the money on their field. Wow. And listen, since you know the river is going to continue to flow, you don't get upset when you see somebody getting rich. Somebody, you know, because you know, steal enough for me. I can still tap in. See, that's one of the mentalities that I think short circuits your pursuit, is you get jealous, you'll never have what you despise. Somebody ought to write that down. You'll never have what you despise. But watch this. All throughout the Bible, we can see God's intervention. That's what I know you want tonight. That's what I needed when I was in a little raggedy building. I needed God to intervene. Because see, here's the thing. There are universal principles that will work for anybody, saved or unsaved. What? Yeah. Remember the Tower of Babel? They were building that tower. That wasn't the will of God. But they were operating in a principle of unity that was going to work. They were operating in the principle of their imagination. It was going to work. Now, there are universal principles in the earth. That's why it's not just Christians who get blessed, not just Christians who increase. That's a better word than just get blessed. Because there are forces, laws, as it were, universal laws. Now, then, when God sends Jesus and he sends the prophets, they are teaching the spiritual or the kingdom law. And God gets involved when you activate a kingdom law, a kingdom principle. That's what sets us apart. See, what sets us apart, and you know, you can go to, and I'm not against, not throwing a rock at them. You know, you can go to a lot of success meetings and that sort of thing, and a lot of people don't know God, don't care about God, you understand? But they are working a principle. I'm telling you, in the kingdom, we have unique principles that will work for us where God says he will get involved. Now, if you need God's intervention in your life, right there in the chat, I want you to come and say, "I need God's intervention. I need God's intervention." Come on, I want you to get involved with me tonight, because in these next several minutes, I'm going to show you how to get God involved in your situation. Had God not gotten involved in that little raggedy building, I don't know where I would be. I'm not trying to take credit for it. God taught me principles. I activated the principles. He got involved, and the rest is history. What? The rest is history. And see, only a God could take a man from that little raggedy building and put the collage up there. Only God could do this, because he showed me the keys of how to increase. Showed me the keys of how to get him involved. I need the collage of churches, if y'all will find that. He showed me those keys. And then on each situation, God got involved. That's why I give him the praise. Isn't that amazing? Look at that. I need it on this screen. Listen, so in every situation, in building and man, all of that, it was God's involvement. And for that, I praise him. All right? I want you to clearly understand. So Abraham, he gets God involved, and Isaac gets God involved. All the scriptures, the widow with the oil gets God involved, you know, feeding the 5,000. And the scriptures simply said, clearly says, because God did it, because God did it. And if he did it for them, he will do it for you. All right. Here's my final point. The empowerment promise of supernatural financial increase. The promise. God makes a promise. And that's when I saw it and I understood that God made a promise that he'd give me wisdom to increase. Tonight, I want to let you know God will give you, yes, he'll give you wisdom. He'll give you creative ideas. That's all in his word. So wisdom is this disciplined approach to living, to operating in a spiritual perspective, using discernment and applying natural and spiritual laws. That's what wisdom, kingdom wisdom, is about. And kingdom wisdom is in the Bible. And this kingdom wisdom, it can be accessed. What? You access the kingdom wisdom. How do I access it? I can access it, number one, by being among the wise, being among people who are doing it. That's why I bring on people like David, and tomorrow we're going to have some other people. I just want you to understand that God's working. He's doing things right now. He's doing things right now. So, kingdom wisdom is gained by association with the wise. It's gained by the divine deposit on the inside of us. Do they hear that? Yeah. It's tapping into the divine positive wisdom on the inside of us. When Jesus comes into our life, he brings all of the attributes and the characters of God already deposited in us. We just need to know how to tap into it, how to wake it up. All right. Then studying to acquire, the Bible says, go to the ant and look at the ant so I can study and acquire it, then asking God for it. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to be asking God. God, show me how to tap into the river of finances. Show me your plan. Give me the favor. Amen and amen. Now watch this. Here's some steps to this resourceful living. Now, resourcefulness is about how to take what I have and use it in amazing ways. I want them to put my definition for resourcefulness there. Resourcefulness. You know, I have to believe, and that's what God taught me to do. He taught me to believe that the answer existed. What? Yeah, he taught me to believe that the answer for my situations, that answer was already, it already, see, because the Bible says he won't let you have a problem for which he doesn't already have the answer. There's a definition. It says resourcefulness is the ability to find quick and clever ways to overcome difficulties. It's not just a practical skill, but it is also a spiritual one that depends upon our reliance on God to provide wisdom, creativity, solutions in challenging situations. Now that's powerful, because he says in 1 Corinthians 10:13, I will not let a problem exist for which I don't already have a solution. There is no temptation taking you but such as common to man. And that word temptation is trial or test. He says, but God is faithful, who will not suffer or allow you to be tried or tested above that you're able, but with the temptation, with the trial, with the test, with the problem, also make a way of escape that you may be able to bear it. All right? And that way of escape is your resourcefulness to overcome your difficulty. Now, what am I saying? I'm saying you got to know how to use your faith to do it. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Wow. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now, here's what I want you to know about faith, and I'm going to teach it on faith on tomorrow. Tonight, today, and tonight, I just wanted to clear it up that scripturally, I got a right to believe for increase. Scripturally, I know God wants me to have increase. God wants me to be resourceful. I got to have that settled confidence that God wants me to have. Now, I had the confidence back then. What? I had the confidence back then. And back then when? I'm talking about in a little raggedy building. And I understood. Put the steps for resourcefulness up here, because I want to talk about those before I wrap up. And that is, number one, I got to ask for God's help, invoke God's help. Number two, I got to take inventory of the giver. What is it that God has given me? And God has given everybody something. Then watch this, I got to involve the group. In other words, I need to collaborate with others. That's why being a part of your church, being a part of others who are going the same way you're going, then they will help me identify the gift. What is it? The gift, all right? The gift is that thing, like the widow's oil. The gift, that is the skill that Peter had to fish. Watch this. Once I've identified the gift, now I inquire of God's wisdom. And the Bible says, when I turn things over to God, Proverbs 16:3, it says, he will cause my thoughts to become agreeable with his will, and so shall my plans be established and succeed. So what does that mean? God says, watch this. He says, now I'm going to innovate with gratitude. I'm going to take the plan that God gives me, and I'm going to innovate that plan. I'm going to implement that plan with gratitude. I'm going after it whole hog, but I'm thankful to God. And watch this, and then I'm going to intentionally glorify God. Now, Isaiah 30:8 is a powerful passage. Isaiah 30:8 says, now, it says, after you succeeded, write it down. Write a book. What? Yeah, it's right there. Write a book. Put it in a book. Document it so that you will have it in the future and others can read it. Wow. So it says, if I've succeeded, I got a right now to use my expertise to help others. That's a stream of income. Amen and amen. Now, here's where I want to close with. I want to close with the regiment of faith for the decisive advantage God wants to give you. You're supposed to have the advantage. Now, I knew I wasn't going to be broke long. What? I'm telling you, I knew it. In fact, back there in the little raggedy building, once I got to Revelation, I was so turned on to this. See, believing is having your will persuaded. My will was so persuaded, I knew it. And I started telling everybody. And they, of course, a lot of them couldn't take it. They couldn't take it. That boy's crazy, but they don't say it anymore. But I'm telling you, this works. Now, I need to put these up there. I need to put those regiments up there. That would be, I think, graph number, it's graph number 7. All right, there it is. So here's what I got to do. See, now this is work. This is work. This is work. Watch this. Number one, I've got to embrace the principle of prayer. What? Yeah, I got to embrace the principle of prayer because prayer is the launching pad for my faith. Number two, I have to embrace the principle of preparation. Bible says, what man gets ready to build a tower that doesn't sit down first and count the cost. So we'll talk about how to plan. Thirdly, I've got to embrace the principle of planting. See, that's the giving part. See, there you go, talking about giving. You have to. We're talking about kingdom. Now, in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, it talks about sowing and reaping, giving a planting metaphor for giving. And it says, watch this, and God is able to make all grace, grace is favor. Favor is the willingness of others to use their power, their ability, and their influence to help you. Nobody makes it without help. Nobody makes it without help. Favor is the willingness of others to use their power, their ability, and their influence to help you. Now, that comes on the heels of giving. It says, and God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. I got to tell you, see, and that's something you have to prove with what you have now. Oh, yeah, one of these days. No. You got to prove what you have right now. I know a lot of times, I got to prove it with what I have now. I got to show that I will be a good steward because if I'm faithful over the little, God will make me ruler over the much. And then God will begin to bring people into my life to help me. Now watch this. I'm in a little raggedy building, 1980, and God asked me for a seed. I'm not going to tell you how much it was, because if it did, it'll shock most of you. You couldn't handle it. But I didn't. I said, God, I don't have that. And then he showed me how to be resourceful to get the seed. And I sowed the seed in the kingdom of God. Now, you understand, back then, I know nothing about John Osteen, nothing about Apostle Price, nothing about Kenneth Copeland. This is revelation I'm getting out of the word, that if things were going to change for me, that I had to be willing to sow a seed. I had to be willing to give an abounding seed. Watch this. I had to be able to give. The Bible says, he that soweth sparingly, but he that soweth, he that soweth bountifully. I had to give a bountiful seed because he was going to change the rules for me. And I did. Child of God, favor exploded over my life. You talk about God intervening? God began to intervene in my life in amazing ways. And I got to tell you, that intervention has not stopped. I am so amazed. That's why when I was talking, David was talking to David, he was talking about, yes, I mean, it's staggering how you see this working for others, but it'll also work for you. All right, watch this. Now, I've got to embrace the principles of perspective. God will show me, he began to show me things. I began to get insight. And then I have to respect the principle of proclamation. I'm going to talk about this on tomorrow. Tomorrow, I'm going to expound on this, how I got to begin to say it, because death and life is in the power of my tongue. And if I believe it, I'm willing to say it. The principle of partnership. God wants me to be a partner with him in the earth. And then finally, the principle of perseverance. And that principle of perseverance is, I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to give up. I told God back then, I'm going to work this principle, and I'm going to see it work in my life. You have a choice. The Bible says you have a choice. The choice you have is to live like you've been living now or choose to live a supernatural life. Choose to live a life trusting God. That's a story I tell. I've been telling it for years. You may have already heard it. Indulge me if you will. So a kid in a candy in a store, and right there at the checkout counter was a big jar of candy. The little kid looks at the candy, and the owner says, reach in there and get you some candy, but the kid would not move. His mother said, it's okay. The kid still would not move. So the owner, it's okay. Your mother said it's okay. Go on in. He still wouldn't move. So in a very frustrating effort, the owner reached in the candy jar and put a handful of candy, gave it to the kid. He stuffed both pockets. Walking out of the store, his mother asked him, Now, I told you it was all right. Why didn't you get some? He said, and even the owner said it was okay. Why didn't you get some? He looks at his mother with big eyes and said, Mama, I looked at his hands. His hands were bigger than mine. And I'm telling you, you got a choice. You can live out of your hands or you can live out of God's hands. I'm here today to tell you his hands are bigger than yours. And I got to tell you, that has made the difference in my life, made the difference in my 40 years of pastoring, all of because I decided one day I'm going to trust God and I'm going to live out of God's hands. And when you make that decision, something supernatural happens when you decide you're going to believe and respond in faith. Abraham believed and responded in faith in the plain, on the plain of Mamre. Moses heard from God and believed and responded in faith there at the burning bush. Gideon in the cave heard from God and responded in faith. And y'all know the rest is history. All throughout the Bible, those who chose to believe and responded in faith, God intervened and something supernatural happened for them. Tonight is your night. Yes, tonight is your night to say, I believe, and I'm going to, it got to be here on tomorrow night so I can show you. See, tonight was just a mentality. Now, tomorrow night is the mechanics. And I know you say, I'm ready. I want to live out of God's hands. Father, thank you for this word. It has fallen on good ground. And I thank you, Father, that those who have heard the word tonight are going to respond in faith saying, I believe and I'm ready to live and embrace the principles of God so that my family and I can be blessed. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen. DJ, give me some music. Give me some music, DJ. Listen. Hey, listen. It's offering time, y'all. It's offering time, and it's time for us to give as we always do. And I know that your giving tonight is going to make a big difference in your life. Now, on all of our times of giving, all of our times of masterclasses, all of the times when we have our showcases, we give an opportunity to give. Now, I want to give because I want to activate some of the, I activate favor in my life. Some of you need a wisdom strategy. And tonight, your income stream wisdom and favor is going to depend on your obedience in your seed. Well, we give not because, you know, we're trying to buy a blessing from the Lord. No, we give because it's expected of God. The Bible says when you come and worship, bring a gift. Secondly, we give because, watch this, our giving expresses our love to God. Yes, because we give to him because we love him. Thirdly, we give, watch this, because it establishes our lordship. He's Lord over all, and I'm saying when I give, Lord, I trust you as source and sustainer of my life. And then we give, watch this, because it eradicates our lack. It eradicates the lack that we have. There is no way around it. There's no shortcut other than the scripture. And the scripture says, if you sow sparingly, you reap sparingly. But if you sow bountifully, you reap bountifully. And so tonight, and for these next 2 days, we have a goal. That's right. We have a goal. And of course, to do all the things that we do. You know, my grandson said to me, he said, now, Big Daddy, you give away too much. I said, No, I give because I want people to have it. And God says, I'm to trust him. Trust that people will hear his voice and people will obey. Now, here's what I'm in faith for this week. I'm in faith this week for 100 people to do $200. What? That's it. You know, if you would go to if you go to one of the success meetings and all that sort of thing, they charge you more than $100 to get in. They do. But I'm saying, watch this. This is not paying. This is a seed. This is a seed. So I want you. Now, remember, I've always said, God puts it in your hand, your heart. He'll put it in your hand. And many of you, you know, $200, you can say, yes, I want to do this. I want you to do it. And then I am believing for 200 people to give $100. And I don't want you to say, oh, man, I'm glad you came down to 100. No. And I'm believing that I will have 300 people who will do $52. You know, that $52 seed is the seed that God told me to ask partners for and people for. Now, that's on that end. Now, you know how we do. We're going to put up the ways that you can give. But I want you, I want to pray because I am looking for catalyst givers at a whole nother level. What? Yes, catalyst givers at a whole nother level. And that is, I'm believing for five people who will give a $1,000 seed. Now, Lady B and I, we're giving $2,000. We're giving $2,000. Now, that's not in the five, but that's in addition to our two. I'm believing for some. I got a lot of you all who are blessed. A lot of you all who say, I'm going to sow this seed because I'm looking for a $1 million idea. I'm sowing this seed because I need a turnaround in my situation. I'm sowing this because I need God to raise up favor. And I got to tell you, the seed God asked me for when I was in a little raggedy building was $10,000. What? Yeah, $10,000. I sowed the seed. Favor exploded over my life. So what I'm asking you to do, and I want to know who you are. I want to know who my five are who will sow a $1,000 seed tonight. I'm going to pray, and y'all know how we do it. We have to use the giving platforms that we have. And I believe at one of the levels, $1,000. You said, well, you didn't say $500. Well, do the five, baby. I'm serious. We're not limited. Yeah, we were on the road one day. Years ago, it was before the pandemic, and I was doing faith tours. And so at the faith tour, I was asked people for $1,000. And after service, a lady came up, one of the partners came up and said, you never called out my amount. And I said, well, you know, no. I said, what was your amount? She said, I have $10,000. I said, well, praise the Lord. And she gave her $10,000. Amen. I'm saying let's obey God tonight. I believe tonight is a kingdom moment. Seriously. I believe it's a kingdom moment, and I don't want you to let this kingdom moment pass you by. Now, whenever I sow into, watch this, the startup of something, you know, it's an amazing promise that I see in the Bible, how God blesses it. Okay, watch this. Peter sowed into Jesus' ministry when he was getting started. See, Max Life Nation is just getting started. We're going to do some amazing things this year. But watch this. When he did, God gave him a boatload of fish. When the widow sowed the cake into the prophet, why? His ministry was just getting started. He had not gone to Mount Carmel or any of that, but the overflow of that seed, I mean, was amazing. She and her house ate many days. So I want you to do that. Now, I think they'd be able to go to the same platform and give that seed. And that's what, MaxLifeTV.org. MaxLifeTV.org/talk. And then you can tell us what your seed is going to be. Now, I need many of you all to do this tonight. Whether your seed is, you'll be one of my $1,000 catalyst givers. You want to give more than that? You can. Or you're going to say, all right, I'll be one of the 200. You got it? Yeah. Our vision goal for this is $50,000 for these next two nights. Can I say that to you? And you'll get in agreement with me for it? Yes. All of us, we have thousands of you watching. Thousands. And that's always a blessing. And we want to say, okay, listen, I'm here to be a blessing to you. Didn't charge you for it. And many people charge, and I don't have a problem. People charge for their master classes. But I'm teaching you this. I'm giving you a lot. All because I believe that you'll respond in faith and you won't be a shoplifter. What's a shoplifter? Shoplifter takes it and don't want to compensate. I believe that you'll say yes. And because you'll say yes, watch this. Favor is going to bound toward you. And listen, I'm going to go back to the main set in just a moment. But what I want to do now, I want you all to begin to show us, and I want you to begin to let me know that, yes, you're going to be a part of the giving experience tonight. And it's going to be good. It's going to be good. So I'm going to let me pray. Father, in Jesus' name, thank you. I've obeyed you. I've shared with the people. We set ourselves in agreement for our $50,000 a budget goal for tonight and tomorrow, and we thank you, Father. Now, Father, I thank you that those that you have spoken to concerning giving the $1,000 tonight, that they are free to obey you, and they'll do so cheerfully. And I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, for the ideas of multiple income streams that will cause wealth to flow into their lives. And so, Father, I thank you now that the eyes of their understanding are open so that, like the widow who did not recognize her oil, I thank you that they began to recognize these skills, talents, hobbies that will be monetized in Jesus' name. And so, Father, I thank you for those who will give at the $200 level. I thank you, Father, that they'll rise up quickly tonight and sow. And those who will sow the $100, they'll do so quickly tonight. And those who will give the $52, they'll do so quickly tonight. And those who will say, I don't have the $52, but I'm going to give something on, and I'm going to believe with you in Jesus' name. So, Father, we count it done in the name of Jesus. And we praise you in advance for it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. All right, now, I think I got a DJ moment here, and then I'm going to join everybody on the platform. Let's go with it. DJ.
Sent their seed. Evangelist Latrice Ryan, $1,000. Taffer Rest Brewer, $200. Pastor Patrick Lagun, $1,000.
All right, that's two.
Bishop John and Aisha Edmondson, $1,000.
That's three.
Cheryl Walker, $200.
Yeah.
MacArthur Davis, $200.
All right.
Pastor Joe Stevens, $100. Jacqueline Hines, $52. E. Deron Cunningham, $100. Lawrence Foreman, $52.
Amen.
Keith Foster, $1,000.
Oh, that's How is it?
Four.
That's four. Okay.
Kobe Wells, $100. Right. And Mo Bennett, $52.
All right, so I'm bleeding for one more for $1,000.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Outstanding.
Yes.
All right, well.
That was awesome teaching, Apostle.
What?
That was awesome teaching.
Amen. I enjoyed it. Of course, you know, my time, the frame that I had, you know, I wanted to maximize my time. Now, tomorrow I'm going to pick it up, and I'm going to talk about mechanics tomorrow.
Okay.
Tomorrow I'll talk about believing, the power of believing. You know, David, when I went to the event that you had, the one here in Houston, and I taught on embracing now maximizing the power of belief. I'm going to teach part of that. Yeah, and you know, your people really loved it. They, you know, they really loved it. In fact, yeah, and you know, the guy who came up after me, all he did was kind of recite. Oh, I'm going, get your own stuff. Yeah, yes, indeed. So listen.
I got one more.
His mic's on.
I have two more.
Okay.
Barbara Jenkins, $1,000.
Amen.
Dexter Easley, $1,000.
Amen. He gives you exceeding abundantly above all you could ask or think. Now, listen, God always does it like that.
Yes, he does.
So there are many more of you who are saying, yes, I need to tap into this, and I want you to obey God. God put $1,000 on your heart. He always does abundance
Always.
Yeah.
And so what I want you to do, I want you to go on, I want you to sow your seed as well.
Yes.
Amen. Now,
yes. And I'll interrupt you if more come in.
Yeah, if more. Now, I want to know. I want to call your name.
Yes.
I want to call your name. Amen and amen.
Yes.
I need my notes from over there, too.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, because you was calling off the different businesses that we had, and I was looking for it on the notes. And
No, not on the notes. I just did that.
Yeah, I was like,
you know, I probably missed one.
I'm sure you missed quite a few.
Yeah, you know, what I wanted to show was, they're going to bring it to me.
Because in 50 years, we've probably done 50 different businesses, probably.
Bridget said 50 years, we've done 50 different businesses.
Probably.
I really wanted people to see and know that we're not just talking about multiple streams.
Right.
You know, because it's one thing, well, what does he know? He's just a preacher. All he know how to do is just preach. No. In fact, we embraced this years ago.
So tell me what you called out, because I walked in on the last part, because I was doing a wardrobe change.
You doing a wardrobe change?
Yes.
Let me see what I called out, because I just jotted these down. I called off, of course, we're in ministry. That's an income stream.
Yes.
The Bible says those who preach the gospel live of the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
Then the aviation, the selling and leasing of aircrafts. The cleaners, the dry cleaners, what we call UCA. I had multi-level back then.
UCA?
Yeah, UCA. Here's what I had. I had people who could go and get their friends and relatives' clothes. They bring them to my cleaners.
Mm-hmm.
And then they get a percentage. And then if they signed up somebody, they could get it. I wrote the whole program and everything. Got it? And I owned the cleaners.
Yeah.
I owned the cleaners and had several locations.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
Yeah.
And sound like a good business.
Watch this.
It was great.
And made money.
Yeah. It was great.
Okay. Then the video game room.
Yes.
Yeah, video game room.
Now, Apostle, I got to say this. I don't know if you mentioned this, but a big income stream is what you do with the money when it comes to investing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I think a lot of people miss that, of knowing where to put the money.
Yeah. Right.
You know, if you, Bitcoin was 9 cents mm-hmm. in 2009.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
If you put $1,000 in Bitcoin, mm-hmm. in 2009, it's 70,000 a coin today.
Wow.
So it's having the knowledge
to know, having
a financial advisor, knowing where to put money, investing. I invested in Facebook a long time ago, Apple a long time ago. So I was smart enough to take the money that I'd made, that God had blessed me with, and sowed it, not just into the kingdom, but also sowed it into opportunities mm-hmm. that pay dividends today.
Absolutely, yeah.
Amen. Then the real estate, that's you.
Yep.
And then the AI venture, that's my new one. Then speaking engagements, mm-hmm. right? Then the computer company we had.
Yes. I heard that one. That was when I came in, I think.
Then consulting, mm-hmm. and then online programs. Do you think anything else? I covered it.
Cufflinks.
That was for the kids.
Well, it still made money.
Yeah, but that was for the kids. I trained my kids in the beginning. I mean, when they were young, I trained them about, they had a cufflink. Cufflinks were real popular.
Mm-hmm.
But we would buy all of the things for them and all of the gems and the, you know, the fasteners and all that. They would put it together and they would sell them to a lot of the preacher friends we had and relatives and that sort of thing.
Value.
And we was teaching them enterprise.
Mm-hmm.
You follow me? And I think Precious was the baby, and she her role was to polish them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was because we could trust her with the glue. But she would polish them, and they would put them in the boxes. And then, you know, I was one of the salesmen. And I tell them, you're going to buy this for my kid.
Most people sell Girl Scout cookies. Y'all sold cufflinks.
Yeah, we were selling cufflinks.
So it was good. Anything else, Bridge?
I can't remember anything.
How about any more giving?
Oh, yes, more giving. I am Terry, $250.
Okay.
Juan Young, $100. And Henrietta Dyer, $52.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Now, that's very good. And I want everybody not to be shoplifters, though.
Yeah.
And that is, I want, you know, I want people to understand. Let me think about it. What would you value? What would you value those CDs at now?
Oh.
I mean, you know, I'm going to say this. Now, what would you value them at?
Honestly, it's a seven figure training. I believe anybody who utilizes it within an 18-month to 3-year time frame can make seven figures.
Wow.
That's real big.
Provided you're in an opportunity where that's right. available. Now, if you're just working a job,
yeah,
you know, I can't. Faith don't work at a job. Faith works, you know, when you've got something that God can bless. So if you're in a business, you have a business, real estate, network market, something.
So do you think it's too much for me to ask those who are getting this for $200, $100 a minute?
No, I don't think so. They should run and do that. That's easy.
I just want y'all to understand. See, I could have said, well, I'm just selling this. No, but I'm believing in you, and I want you to get this.
Yeah.
And that's one of the passions that Lady B and I have had over the years, is we wanted people to get it. And so we've taught it on all kinds of platforms, but tonight I need your support. Mm-hmm. Need your support to do all that I want to do. I need your support. So I want you to make that sacrifice, if it's a sacrifice for you. So I don't have 52. Do what you can. I want everybody who's watching to do what you can. Now, wouldn't you want God to intervene and give you a creative strategy and a creative idea?
Yeah.
Wouldn't you want that to happen? Because show you what you have. Yeah. See, and that's the whole thing. You already have it, you just don't see it.
Mm. Right.
You know, you already have it, but you just don't. But, and when you know it and you begin to apply it, you're gonna see the increase. Mm. Amen and amen. Where you got that, Bridge?
I'm getting ready to sow our seed.
Oh, you're sowing our seed?
Yes.
Amen. All right.
While you were talking.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we believe in it enough to sow into it ourselves. Okay.
Is it supposed to go into Max Life Nation?
What are we sowing under? Y'all didn't tell me. Y'all
I didn't. It's got different drop downs.
Okay. Somebody.
They probably need to put the giving platforms
back up. Put the giving platforms back up so we'll know.
And then. Max Life Nation.
They saw it in Max Life Nation?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Saw it in the Max Life Nation. Amen. All right. Praise the Lord. Okay, where are we supposed to go now? We're supposed to go to John? Supposed to go to John. All right.
He had a wardrobe change, too.
Oh, he had a wardrobe change?
Yes.
Did he?
Yep.
All right, we're going back to our guest MC, Bishop Edmondson. And we'll be right back after this.
Hey, I'm back again, and wardrobe change. We change wardrobe here at Max Life Nation. Isn't that nice? Look at that. Isn't that wonderful? Now, what I love tonight, I know you agree, that teaching was awesome. Was that not awesome? And what I love so much is not only does Apostle and Pastor B give revelation like that, but then they understand how the devil tries to come at you and go, that's never possible for me. I could never accomplish that. So then they're going to give away. David said that's a seven-figure investment if you wanted to charge for it. They're going to give away eliminating doubt and unbelief. So here's your homework. Here's your application. You need to go to maxlifetv.org/talk and get it. You can get, they're giving it away for free. What is going on? You need to go do that tonight because it will build your faith, eliminate doubt and unbelief, so you can step up to that place of saying what Apostle taught tonight, it's possible for me as well. Now, don't forget the polling question. The question is, who was most likely to succeed in developing multiple income streams, male or female? I believe Apostle said males, emphatically, males. Pastor B said females. We want to know, what do you say? Just like Jesus said, who do they say? But then he said, forget, what do you say? We want to know what you say. Now, you know, I'm going to just stick with Pastor B. I'm just going to stick with Pastor B. I'm rolling with Pastor B. But what do you say? Because, you know, who do you think would earn more, multiple income streams, succeed better, male or female? Put it in the chat. We want to know what you think tonight. because we want to hear from you. It's going to be really, really good. Now, also, we're getting ready to do a segment you don't want to miss. It's been fantastic up until this point, but we're getting ready to do a segment on Ask the Millionaire. Now, when do you get a chance to sit down and ask a millionaire questions? Well, that's how we roll here at Max Life Nation. You don't want to miss this. Now, we want you to send in your question. We don't want you to observe. We want you to send in your question. So again, the way you do that is maxlifetv.org/talk, and you can ask a question, and we're getting ready to go to Apostle and Pastor B and David, and they're going to answer your questions. There's no unwise question except the one you don't ask. Take advantage of what God has given you tonight. Get your question answered. This is going to be good. Don't forget, go get your free product. Go get your free product. He's giving that away for free. What is going on? Get the free product, but go ahead and ask your question now, because they're ready to answer your questions. And I believe tonight you get an answer that changes the trajectory of your life so that you can begin to produce like you've been hearing tonight and you're going to hear tomorrow night. It's incredible. I'm ready to ask my question. I'm going to turn around and ask mine, because I want some answers. I need some answers. So get ready. Ask your question. We're getting ready to ask a millionaire. It's going to be great. Check this out.
He said he's going to ask a question.
Oh, my God. This is amazing. Okay.
I have lots of questions.
Okay, so here's what we're going to do.
What are we going to do?
We're going to do this section, and then at the end of this session, we're gonna go to the giveaways.
Okay.
We're gonna go to the giveaways, and we're gonna wrap it up after that. Man, I think tonight has already been great. It's been amazing.
Wow.
So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do the Ask a Millionaire, Ask the Millionaire. And then after that, we'll jump to the giveaways, and then we'll let Edmonds and Matt wrap it up.
Okay.
And so we should be able to stay within our time frame that we wanted.
Okay.
Okay, millionaire, you ready?
Ready.
Do you want to call off these last couple of?
Okay. Yeah. Call off the gifts for sure.
Tyrone Marion, $52.
All right.
Nalithia Hollis, $20.
Thank you.
Joan Bass, $52.
All right.
And LaVaria Wilson, $52.
Amen.
And
Amen.
The comments are that the masterclass and the Max Life Nation showcase tonight has been amazing.
Amen.
And then Nancy Rivera, $200.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Because I need really a lot of you to just obey God with that $200.
Lois Leonard, $200.
Thank you, Lois. Amen. I need many more of you all to do that. Don't think that somebody else is going to do it. Mm-hmm. Don't think it. Now listen, let's ask the millionaire, and then we'll come back and we'll wrap everything up for tonight.
Okay. Where is a good place to start when looking for additional income?
A good place to start. What value do you bring to the world?
Okay.
That's the first thing you've got to say. Money is in other people's pockets. That's where it's not in the bank. It's in other people's pockets. But people will not give you their resources unless you have something of value that they want. So the question is, what do you have in your hand? Do you have a skill?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you have a skill that people will pay for? That skill could be an orator.
Right.
Right. That skill could be a hairdresser. That skill could be, a mechanic. Do you have a skill? A lot of people are selling courses.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're selling courses on how to do something.
Yeah.
Right. So you've got to figure that out. Learning how to trade is one thing that a lot of people do. Learn how to trade, you know, foreign exchange or cryptocurrency. So you got to figure out what value can you bring to the world, and the world will exchange their resources for the value that you bring.
Right, and people overlook their value.
Yeah.
I was, the other day, I had a lady, her husband came to me and said, I'm gonna have my wife make you a key lime pie.
Mm-hmm.
I said, I love key lime pie. Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that pie was amazing.
Mm.
So I go back to him, I said, listen, you need to sell this.
Value.
No, I just want to judge. I said, no. You like money. You want money. I said, people will pay for this.
Yeah.
I
That was the Ivy key lime pie all over the world. Mm. That's the best key lime pie I've ever eaten.
Wow. That's what she should call it. The best key lime pie.
I'm telling you.
The best key lime pie.
Again, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Now, there was a guy in Indiana. I'm going to let you ask another question. Guy in Indiana, his name Big Daddy. He may be watching. But Big Daddy, I was at the church preaching, and they gave me some of his barbecue. And I said, where is this guy? And I said, I don't know what you're doing for a living now, but you need to quit it. And you need to do this full time. He did it.
Big Daddy Barbecue?
Big Daddy Barbecue. And he got two locations. Watch this. He got his own barbecue sauce. I can't get close to Indiana. If I'm in Chicago, somehow or another, they get me some of Big Daddy's barbecue.
Yes. God is always going to use what's in your hand. That's what you taught on that.
Yeah.
It's going to be what's in your hand first.
Yes.
And then how can he multiply that? How can he grow that and bless that?
Now, tomorrow night, I'm going to be teaching on that.
Mm, okay.
Because I'm going to be teaching you how to recognize what's in your hands. Mm. Okay, Lady B, next question to ask the millionaire.
It's actually twofold.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, one, it says, is it easy to join your network marketing company? And then how do I get involved in your direct marketing venture? And what is the minimum amount needed to get started?
Okay. Yes, it's very simple to get involved in the company. The minimum to get started is
$25.
Yeah, that's the minimum.
Wow.
Yeah, it's the very minimum. The highest is $1,200. But a person can start the business for $25.
Wow.
Yeah.
$25.
And have the potential of making.
Oh. Whatever you can believe for.
And what the?
They can go to envisionyou.com.
Okay.
And they can enroll there. So N, the letter N, the word vision, the letter U.com, and they can enroll there as a visionary.
Can I get credit for them enrolling?
Absolutely.
Since I asked the question.
Absolutely. they just need to put your name. When it says search who told you, they can put your name in there. And
y'all,
you're good to go.
Did y'all heard it from me? Mm-hmm. When the search engine says who told you, put my name.
Yes.
Because I asked the question. No. Somebody actually on here. Okay. What industries do you think will produce the most millionaires in the next 5 to 10 years?
I think health and wellness is always going to be big because people are always going to be concerned about their health and their wellness. I believe technology is going to be big because it's always innovating, it's always changing, it's always growing. I would say those two areas, utilizing social media right now is huge. You've got to figure out a way to get your business, your concept, right, your idea on the digital platform to where eyeballs can see it. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if you have a health and wellness product, technology is how can I get what it is that I have, how can I make it easier for someone to actually utilize it? So I would say those are two areas that I would really, really focus on right now. Okay. If you look at billionaires, a lot of them, that the health is really where they're moving to.
Health and wellness.
Yeah.
Okay, do you adhere to a strict daily schedule for your personal life and business life? If so, what does that regimen look like?
I've never done that. That's never been my MO. But I will tell you this, every day I do believe. Every day I do practice some sort of gratitude. Every day I will feed my spirit man and I learned this from you as well. Within one of the five senses, whether it's me listening to the word or some type of worship or praise, right? So that my spirit man stays on point, because that's how I dominate the earth. I dominate the earth with my spirit man, not my physical man or not my soulish man, but keeping my spirit man up.
Mm-hmm. All right.
This one is more, I guess, maybe for you, Apostle. It says, how do you use the principle of meditation specifically? Hmm. What things do you meditate on and what scriptures do you incorporate in your regimen?
Okay, tomorrow night. That's all I can say. No, that's the lesson for tomorrow night.
Meditation.
The lesson for tomorrow night is meditation manifestations. Mm. How to meditate so that you can get the manifestation.
Can I say something?
Sure.
That's CD number 3.
It is.
Yeah.
It is.
That's number three. If you got that.
Success without meditation.
Yeah, if you got that, CD number three will teach that. You can listen to that tonight before tomorrow. Tomorrow will be a refresher.
Exactly.
Yeah, but that's it. And everything I've done, I've used the principle of meditation.
Yeah. Everything.
Yeah. Even today.
Yeah. That's one of the five senses of the spirit, right? Meditation?
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm of the sort. Yes, it is. Yeah.
Okay.
So
he went way back on a teaching on that one.
Oh, yeah.
Go on.
That's 04.
Yeah.
One of Apostle's steps is role models that are to be discovered from the past one seeks. Where do millionaires hang out, like yourself, network, and where do they network?
Well, I'll tell you, you've got to put yourself in the room. You've got to put yourself, and it costs. So when Apostle is up there and he says, hey, listen, give 200. I want you to understand, I've paid hundreds of thousands of dollars to be in rooms with multimillionaires, even billionaires, that I can learn from. Because there's power in proximity. So if you say, hey, be careful what you ask for. If you say you want to be in those rooms, you can't come in there penny pinching.
Right.
You're going to have to make the investment because these people, they're not in ministry.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay. It costs to actually get into those rooms. So what I did in the very beginning, I would listen to them. Right. So John C. Maxwell is a close friend and a mentor of mine as well. And I listened to him for many years. Now, I didn't get close to him until I invited him to speak at an event.
Right.
Now, the cost to get him to speak at an event
is significant.
It's a little bit more than $200.
It's very significant. I do know.
It's a little more than $1,000, right?
A little bit more.
But now, because I was able to get close to him, now we've got a personal relationship where I can get in those rooms and where I've met a lot of other successful people through him. So I would start with listening to them on a daily basis, right? And then there's seminars, there are conferences that you can go to that maybe not going to cost you $5,000, $10,000 to go to, but it's going to cost you. It's not going to be free. And that's why it's so powerful what you're doing, because you can get this information for free.
Yeah.
But am I doing a disservice to them?
Well, you're not, because you're in ministry.
Right.
And because you're a giver.
No, I'm just saying.
They should just take advantage of it, because if you were in the circular world,
okay,
based on what I know, what you could command, it's six figures, multiple six figures to show up,
right,
in the circular world. So them having access to this information for free, because you're not even charging for it. You're saying, I'm going to give it to you for free, but then I'm going to allow you to use a principle that's going to allow you to get increased by saying so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Right. So it's not even going to you. It's actually for them.
Yeah.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the thing. I know, Bridget, you probably got another question, but I know I really want people to get this. Mm-hmm. I know what it is to be without. I know what it is to struggle.
Mm-hmm.
I know what it is not to have the knowledge I should have because I am a believer. How you be in church, but very few have the boldness to teach it.
Yeah.
Because, the rocks that get thrown at you and that sort of thing. I think several years ago we were talking and you said, I can make as much money as I want to make. Because I'm not a pastor.
I can't.
I saw your new car that you bought you.
Yeah.
I mean, that thing is nice.
Thank you, sir.
That thing is nice. I'm telling you. It's
crypto bought it for me.
Oh, okay. Your investment bought it?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. I didn't use my money.
Amen. Yeah. I mean, it's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
You got it? And I already know I get some heat because I'm saying I'm willing to teach you how to get out of poverty because I know poverty stinks.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
When I knew I had a right to it, things changed for me.
Yeah. I have a question.
Sure.
Why is it that people think that what God has done for you or done for another, why don't they take ownership of it and say, well, if he'll do it for the Hilliards, I mean, he's going to do it for me? Because I remember listening to the audio, and I remember this point in there I think this was high finance.
Okay.
And the guy, you said you were pulled up in the Rolls Royce, and the guy was like, there he go. You know, and I pictured, I saw that happening for me. Mm-hmm. What happened for you, I saw it happen for me listening to the tape. Why do you think so many people miss out on the blessing of what's happened in your life? That blessing can come to me as well.
Well, I think it's a stronghold, David. Mm. I think they grow up, we grow up with this disdain for people who have. Mm. And I can never claim what I disdain. Mm. You follow me? And so that stronghold, that mental thought pattern of, there you go,
right.
Follow me. Mm. And because of that, that stronghold, it has to be broken.
Yeah.
It's got to be broken with the Word of God. That's why I'm so adamant about teaching it. Got it? And you know, okay, here's a money grubber. I could care less.
Yeah.
Because right, if two or three people get the breakthrough, I'm happy every time I get up.
Amen.
Because I believe, Lady B and I believe in this.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
You got it? And you know, we are tremendous givers into the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
You know, like you wouldn't hardly believe.
Mm-hmm.
But the whole point of it is, man, that stronghold's got to be broken.
Yeah.
It's got to be broken off of our people.
Mm-hmm.
Because all they've been taught in church is I go to church, I have a good time and meet friends. You got it? When you should go to be empowered.
Yeah.
Right.
You need to be in a place that's going to teach you. And so, you know, Dr. I has this conference that's coming up, C. Rose Lee's conference on boldness. Mm-hmm. I believe every woman who has that entrepreneur spirit ought to be here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I mean, everyone ought to be here.
Yeah.
I mean, young or old, and then you're never too old. That's not, guys, oh my God. Because, you know, the older you are, the more expertise you have. You just need to know how to package it.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
You follow me? And if you know how to package it, and that's the partnership with others, my God,
never
it's not too late for you to be rich.
Never too late.
But see, somebody told you it was.
Mm.
See, somebody told you it's late, it's too late for you. Abraham didn't get started. Till 75. Moses didn't get started till 80. Caleb didn't get started till 85. And here you are 60 counting yourself out.
Yeah.
Can we get one more question and then we're going to start wrapping up? It's going to be giveaway time in just a moment.
So you answered one of the questions about would it work at any age? And that was, of course, absolutely it will.
Amen.
But this one I think is really good. It says, if you lost everything, but you had $1,000 left, where would you invest that money today?
Well, the first thing I would do is I would change my confession of I lost everything.
Exactly.
I cannot operate victoriously operating as a victim.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Because you didn't lose everything because you never had everything.
Right.
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 Exactly.
So that's the first thing I would do. $1,000 to my name, what would I do? I would sew it.
And that's exactly what I was going to say.
Because
I think the greatest investment that me and Apostle have ever made is our giving. Our giving into
I
the
would
kingdom
sew it.
Of God. That's what I said too. I would sow it.
Yeah.
I would give it.
I learned if I hold on to it, it's my harvest.
Right.
If I let it go, it's my seed.
Yeah.
And the seed is always smaller than the harvest.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
So if what I have is enough, then I hold on to it.
Right.
But if it's not enough, I need to put it in the ground so it can give me a better harvest.
Exactly. That was going to be my answer as well.
Yeah.
I was going to say sow it. I think.
Seed time of harvest.
Yeah. And then, you know, I'm not sure who was the originator of it, but I've heard somebody say that if it doesn't meet my need, it's a seed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
True.
So, yeah.
You know, we have another product that we want to talk about tonight as we wrap up. The Millionaire Boot Camp.
It's coming around.
Yeah, the Millionaire. No, I have it. I packaged it.
Okay.
It's called the Millionaire Boot Camp Experience.
All right.
Got it?
Okay.
Those 2 days I packaged. Got it? I want y'all to get that spot ready.
You're not giving that for free.
Huh?
You're not giving that for free.
You like my stamp. And I'm going to tell you the story behind that, too. And we're going to talk about that before we do the giveaway. But that It was amazing. Do they have that ready real quick so they could do that? I know I'm changing everything. They got it ready. Play that, and then we're going to come right back, and we're going to talk about that, do the giveaways, and we're going to wrap this up. But I tell you, I'm not giving it free.
No.
No, not that one. I'm not
going
to allow him to give it free.
I was thinking. All right, play that right now.
Those who attended this blockbuster two-day event said it was an experience of a lifetime to sit at the feet of millionaire entrepreneurs to learn their secrets and motivations. They came wanting answers and strategies because they knew millionaire status was possible for them. It has paid off. What they paid thousands of dollars for is now available to you in the Millionaire Bootcamp experience that is accessed through Hilliard Faith University. Learn how to monetize your hobbies, get money to work for you, and much more. All of the lectures and panel discussions are all here in the Millionaire Bootcamp experience. It's yours on demand for the investment in yourself for only $4.99. This is the key to your step to millionaire status. Did you know that there are 1,700 people who become new millionaires each day? Why not you? Did you know that 86% of millionaires say that they earned their wealth and didn't inherit it? Why not you? Order the Millionaire Experience today. Text MLN dollar sign E to 54244. Why not you? Why not now?
Praise God.
Now,
An investment.
That's an investment, David. You know, baby shop wasn't going to give it away. But I was almost going to give it
away. No.
I got what I call my A-team. These are people that kind of advise me. You're part of the A-team of how to, you know. So I was talking to one of the A-team people who advised me, who said, man, if we could get our hands on that, people get their hands on that, it would be great, because they paid $1,000.
Mm-hmm.
And then the regular registration, like $1,600.
Right.
And people paid it.
Of course.
So I said, well, what do y'all think about $50? And they said, oh, no, not possible. That's not going to happen. That's a slap in everybody's face who paid the money.
Mm-hmm.
I said, well, I guess y'all right. That's safety in the multitude of counsel.
Right.
What do you think about that? Because you were there.
No, I think that's going to really move around the world right there. The key is we got to get the eyeballs on it.
Yeah.
We got to get enough eyeballs, because to get that group of people together for those 2 days, $500, that's nothing.
Yeah.
And then you have it forever.
Right.
Right.
You know, so.
Well, that's, you know.
And the thing of it is that the people that were there, they didn't get an opportunity to get it packaged so that they could have it.
Right. Right.
They actually just had to absorb the information right there. So now they can get it and listen to it over and over again.
Well, that was one of the team. One of the person on the A team says, yes, I wish I could get my hands on that.
Yeah.
Because I didn't offer it.
Yeah.
Right.
No, I didn't offer it. And so I said, okay. And so that's when I said, you've been for $50. So they were there, paid the $1,000, mm-hmm. and want to get it for the price.
Yes. 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 And it's $500. If you listen to it 10 times, it's just $50 a listen.
Yeah.
No, and everybody who speaks was a millionaire.
Yeah.
Remember that? Multi.
Everybody who spoke was a millionaire. Mm-hmm. Nobody on that platform was not a millionaire. Everybody was.
Yeah.
You got it? And so, somebody was just talking about getting in the room.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way to get in the room.
That's mm-hmm. the way to listen.
That's the way to get in the room. Yeah. And oh my God! And the things that came out, you know, it was a toxic, you know. But I mean, and you know, you helped me on it, you understand, and helped me get these millionaires, the females and all, in the room.
Mm-hmm.
And what the lawyer said just blew everybody away.
Mm-hmm. Wow!
About how many people who get rich and lose their riches.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just the whole thing is life changing. Now I'm believing tonight for 10 people.
To get
10 people tonight will say, I got to have it.
It'll be more than that.
You think so?
Yeah, it'll be more than that.
It'll be more than
you
that.
You think we got more people than that?
It'll be more than that.
It'll be more
you
than that.
Run that spot again, run it again. It'll be more
it'll
than 10
be
people
much
get
more
that.
Than it. Yeah. I'm in agreement with
you. You think so?
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Okay. And they have it available on your page.
Yeah, we'll
put it out there. We just want to introduce it tonight.
Okay.
Tonight's the first night everybody's hearing.
As soon as I see it on your page, I'm going to send it out. I'm going to send it out to my network.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. See, that's really a blessing.
They need that.
Okay, what you got, Bridge?
I have more offerings. Terry and Kimberly King, $200.
All right.
Mo Bennett again, seed $100. Pastor Darren Golston, $200.
All right.
Chris Givens, $52. Ray and Latanja Young, $200.
All right.
Adrian Meekins, $200.
Okay.
Tina Scalady, $25. Melissa Waller, $52. Love the People Ministries, Dr. Ellen Cooper, $100. Tiffany Johnson, $52, and Diana Graham, $200.
All right, we got to wrap it up.
Yep.
Got to wrap it up, got to wrap it up.
I have giveaways, right?
Giveaways, what are we going to do?
I'm supposed to call their name, and then they need to be listening right now, and they have to call this number. If I call your name, you need to call.
What's going to be the giveaway first? Let's be the first giveaway, the merch.
Okay.
The merch.
So the merch is the first giveaway, so that when they call this number, they need to tell them their size.
Right.
So it's 855-955-1850. 855-955-1850. But I have to call your name, so make sure you don't be calling if I didn't call your name.
Okay. Are the phones ready? They're ready? Okay. Let's do it.
Okie dokie. Let's see. Let me get the name.
And John, get ready to wrap it up, because we got to get out of here.
Yep. So, the first name is Lacosa Wade. Lacosa Wade is from South Carolina.
Give two names, because we're going to give away two merch.
Adrian Fincher from New York.
Okay. The clock is ticking. You got 30 seconds to call.
30 seconds to call.
All right. I don't hear the phones ringing. 30 seconds. Here's the countdown. All right. Let's talk for 20 more seconds.
Talk for 20 more seconds.
Mm-hmm. Yes, 20 more seconds. David, thank you for coming, man. I really appreciate you.
It was so
coming.
Good having
thank
you live. Yeah.
It's a minute and a half behind this one,
too. Oh, that's true.
Okay, it's a minute and a half behind, so they're just hearing it now. Okay, all right, I got that. Again, David, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
And, you know, hey, man, we wish you well in your company, man.
Yes, sir.
I believe some people tonight are going to say, let me look into that.
Hey.
Yeah, they're going to sign up.
And they're going to sign up. I mean, that's good. It's all good.
Oh, we could do the poll.
Oh, yeah. Let's do the poll. So, okay. So all right. Des, bring the poll up.
Who won?
Who won the poll? I know who won.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, yeah.
What was that?
What was the number I said?
3%.
What was the number
you
I said?
75.
Five, yeah.
Okay, we have an error. There's got to be an error.
But listen to David's statistics says. Uh-uh. 72%, 75% of direct marketers are females.
Oh, women, yes.
But 75% of the
top earners
are men, males.
Or basically couples.
Couples.
I mean, a lot of couples.
Oh, well, that wife did it.
Yeah.
Oh, really? you throw the brothers under the bed? Huh? Oh, really?
It's a team effort.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I take that off the screen. All right, good. Did our people call?
Did anybody call? No call.
Yeah. Give us two more names.
Well, we know these two are gonna be responding. Number three, and it was not fixed. It's Avery Meekins.
Okay.
And Pam Peavy.
Pam Peavy. Pam was here, wasn't she?
She was here earlier, I think, but she.
Okay, they get the merch. Now, drum roll. Okay, I want you. I need some powerful music. We're about to give away $15,000.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Okay, get ready for the $15,000 scholarship giveaway. Okay, Bridget.
Darian James from Texas, here in Texas.
Darian James, call right away. Call right away.
D-A-R-R-I-N, James, from Texas.
Give us a 2-minute countdown on that. And if we don't get it tonight, we'll give away 2 tomorrow night.
Yep.
Darren James, okay.
This was great tonight.
Thank you.
I thought tonight was good. My DJ was good.
DJ was awesome.
You did a good job.
DJ Marcus, right?
I like what y'all did with the playlist. Y'all made it all instrumental.
Yeah. You know, that's Dr. I. She's the executive producer. She stepped in.
Your playlist, he said.
Dr. I stepped in. You know.
No, but the playlist I sent her is not instrumental. So. They have words with it. So you just took all of them and made it instrumental.
Well, it's all good. It's
great. I like it. Because I don't know what words spoke about it.
Okay, here's what we're going to do.
Holy. They weren't. Not holy, but.
Okay. Listen, y'all, I got to get out of here. Here's what we're going to do. I'm changing things.
We got to go back to Bishop Edmonds.
Yeah, I'm going to change things, but I'm going to get ready to throw it to Bishop in just a minute. But what I want to do, I want to play a spot one more time.
Yes.
I want to play the spot one more time for the experience. Mm-hmm. I want to play the spot then after the experience, he's going to take us home.
Makes sense.
Are we ready?
Hopefully, Darren.
I'm changing it. Okay, they got thumbs up. So they're going to play the spot on the experience. The Millionaire Bootcamp experience. Yeah. And y'all saying more than 10 people.
Oh, yeah.
More than 10.
For sure.
Okay, we're going to see tonight. Amen.
Tonight.
Play the spot after the spot. Come back to John. Wrap it up the way it's on the paper. I see y'all on tomorrow night. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Whom shall I fear?
Strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies, foes, came on me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and fail. No war rise against me. In this will I be confident.
One thing have I desired
of the Lord, that I'll seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Inquire in his temple. Hath thou not known? Hath thou not heard God, the everlasting Father, creator of the ends of the earth? He fainteth not, neither is he weary. And there is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint. And to them who have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, mount upon wings as eagles, run and not be weary, walk and not faint. Who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? He'll grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He's despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid as it were our faces from him. He's despised and we esteemed him not. Surely he's borne our griefs, carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him smitten, stricken of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Stay focused, stay in faith, watch your mouth, and let's watch God work. Boom.
Those who attended this blockbuster 2-day event said it was an experience of a lifetime to sit at the feet of millionaire entrepreneurs to learn their secrets and motivations. They came wanting answers and strategies because they knew millionaire status was possible for them. It has paid off. What they paid thousands of dollars for is now available to you in the Millionaire Bootcamp experience that is accessed through Hilliard Faith University. Learn how to monetize your hobbies, get money to work for you, and much more. All of the lectures and panel discussions are all here in the Millionaire Bootcamp experience. It's yours on demand for the investment in yourself for only $4.99. This is the key to your step to millionaire status. Did you know that there are 1,700 people who become new millionaires each day? Why not you? Did you know that 86% of millionaires say that they earned their wealth and didn't inherit it? Why not you? Order the Millionaire Experience today. Text MLN$E to 54244. Why not you? Why not now?
Listen, all I can say is wow. Tonight, wow. Just phenomenal. I know you enjoyed yourself. I know this blessed you on so many levels, so many components tonight. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now here's a question. Have you joined the nation?
Have you joined the Nation Apostle and Pastor B? They're recruiting Max Life Nation. But you got to join. If you haven't joined, what you waiting for? You can go to maxlifetv.org/talk and join the Nation tonight. This is one of so many different things that Max Life Nation offers. You got to join the Nation. What are you waiting for? If you're part of the Nation, put it in the chat. Join tonight. Join tonight. It'll bless your life. Now, here's the cool thing. Tonight was just part one. It was just part one. There's a part two coming tomorrow, and you don't just need to come on. You need to get the word out. If tonight blessed you, there's at least five people you know it'll bless them. Get the word out. Let people know, listen, you got to watch this tonight. You got to be a part of it. Tomorrow night, it's going to be phenomenal. It's going to be fantastic. And Apostle just laid foundation tonight. Tomorrow, we're going to a whole nother level, and you want to be on and watch. Now, also, you want to get some merchandise. Isn't this cool? Look, I changed clothes. We had a changing tonight. Isn't this awesome? You're not dressing if you're not wearing a Max Life hoodie. You got to get you a Max Life Nation hoodie. So go ahead, get your hoodie, man. Again, maxlifetv.org/talk. Order your hoodie so you in style. What are you waiting on? You're going to look good like me. And then I'm real excited about this. That millionaire bootcamp experience, did you hear the number? Every day, 1,700 new people are millionaires. Why not you? Why not tomorrow you one of those 1,700? Why not this year you're one of those 1,700? That's why you got to get eradicating doubt and unbelief, because it is possible for you. So go ahead and order. This has been a fantastic evening, man. I love it. I know you were blessed, and you need to go ahead and take some action. Get your hoodie. Go ahead and register. If you want giveaways, you got to register. Register now. Again, maxlifetv.org/talk. Register. Don't forget about tomorrow night, man. It's going to be up. This has been off the charts crazy tonight. And if you thought tonight was good, tomorrow's going to be even, I want to say gooder. That's not a word. It's going to be great tomorrow night. Well, I'm so excited. It's been my pleasure to host you. Now, Pastor was like, the DJ was good, but he didn't tell me I was good. I was good. You, if I was, put in the chat, he was good. I was good. But it was great, man. That's been so exciting to host tonight. I'm really honored and privileged to hang out tonight. Can't wait till tomorrow, man. We are going to just kick it off to another level. All right, we're going. There's some video shots coming. Check out the spots, and then we'll see you tomorrow night. Talk to you soon.
Age is more than a number. It's a story of triumph, learning, and boldness. This is Dr. Irisha inviting women of all ages to She Rose League Conference, April 24th through the 27th. From young visionaries to esteemed pioneers, this conference is a melting pot of experiences and wisdom. Together, we'll share, grow, and empower each other no matter the stage of life you're in. Seize this opportunity to be a part of a diverse and vibrant community. Register now and join us in this celebration of timeless boldness. Register at SheRoseLeague.com, and I'll see you at She Rose League 2024.
It's the showcase of all showcases. The March Max Life Nation showcases a two-day event back-to-back with the Apostle of Faith, Apostle Ivy Hilliard, focusing on faith for multiple income streams. Do you need more money? Are you ready to know how to monetize the hobbies, skills, and talents you have? March 26th and 27th at 7 p.m. Central each night, the showcase will stimulate your faith, stir up your creativity, and more. And registration is critical for the full experience. Apostle Hilliard and his iconic guests are none other than millionaire entrepreneur David Immonite and others. It's the back-to-back showcases you won't want to miss. Registration is free, so do it now for the merch giveaways, masterclass lessons, worksheets, and more. Text MNMAS to 54244. If you want to stay in a financial rut, just ignore this invitation, and we apologize for taking up your time. But if you are like so many who want better but just need the coaching push, you will register today. The Hilliards have coached so many in successful living, and they are ready to help you. Don't do what poor people do. They procrastinate and wait. Register now. Text MNMAS to 54244.
Yo, it's the kid, it's Pastor Ivan, and we slashed the price. It's time to reserve a spot for your teen group for June and July summer camps here at Love City USA in Houston, Texas. Listen, we have slashed the price just like last year. We are doing the same thing this year for this four-day summer camp experience at Love City USA, and I'm telling you, it's going to be absolutely amazing. For just $199 per camper, we are making it possible for more teens to attend. Love City USA is in the shadows of downtown Houston, and it is a place of fun, fellowship, and faith with first-class air-conditioned dormitories, a cafeteria, and state-of-the-art worship facilities. Our theme this year is Chosen. We want each and every teen to understand that they have a purpose and are chosen by God to make a difference in life. Teen groups will come from across America this summer to experience this amazing teen-sensitive spiritual encounter, and we would love to host your group. For more information, text LCUSA24 to 54244. Yeah, it's right there on the screen. Or go to lovecityusa.com and treat your teen to an experience that will last you a lifetime. I want to see you in Love City. Can't wait. Let's go.
So there are black people throughout the Bible that no one talks about. Learn the calculated psychological conspiracy to keep this knowledge hidden to promote white supremacy and black inferiority. This is not unknown. It is just untaught. It's time the intentional lies are dispelled as these profound truths are brought to light. The Hidden Light Matrix, the literary product that is transforming the thinking of millions. It exposes the mind control used to keep the slaves divided that is still used today to indoctrinate people of color. You will never read the Bible the same way again after knowing how to identify black people and the role they play in the plan of God. It will amaze you. Order your copy now, only $29.95 while supply lasts. The question this generation has is, do black people play a role in biblical history? And the answer is a resounding yes, yet these facts were intentionally excluded. It's time this hidden light be hidden no more. Those who attended this blockbuster two-day event said it was an experience of a lifetime to sit at the feet of millionaire entrepreneurs to learn their secrets and motivations. They came wanting answers and strategies because they knew millionaire status was possible for them. It has paid off. What they paid thousands of dollars for is now available to you in the Millionaire Bootcamp experience that is accessed through Hilliard Faith University. Learn how to monetize your hobbies, get money to work for you, and much more. All of the lectures and panel discussions are all here in the Millionaire Bootcamp experience. It's yours on demand for the investment in yourself for only $4.99. This is the key to your step to millionaire status. Did you know that there are 1,700 people who become new millionaires each day? Why not you? Did you know that 86% of millionaires say that they earned their wealth and didn't inherit it? Why not you? Order the Millionaire Experience today. Text MLN $E to 54244. Why not you? Why not now?